an iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod, a phone. This is one device. And we are calling it iPhone.
The smartphone. I own one, you own one, and so does everyone else you know. They have various uses and have managed to capture the attention of nearly every person on the face of the planet. The overwhelming use of telecommunications devices in the modern world has offered the human race the ability to talk with people hundreds of kilometers away, all with the tap of a button. Although quite powerful, this ability has begun to erode the face-to-face contact the human race had once become so accustomed to. I wanted to take a deeper delve and find out where others might sit on the subject.
Hi, my name is Ainsley MacDonald.
Hi, I'm Justin Michaud. I think definitely people are becoming less independent by themselves and are using their phones much more than we need to and avoiding like social contact a lot for sure.
I feel like it's essential, but it's overused and it can be a bit harmful to some people.
Normally, I find myself interacting with people in person. It depends really on the time. If it's late, then I'm not going to be going out to see people. So I play games online. I use Discord and stuff on computer. Sometimes I use my phone to text people.
A lot of my friends don't live near me, so I do interact with people digitally almost every single night. But I do prefer physically. I feel like you can connect with people more. And I just feel like actually being around someone and being in their space, it's just like, it's refreshing.
It's no secret that people enjoy staying in touch with one another. It's in our DNA. Beginning with the invention of the phone in the late 1800s, the human race has quickly become dependent on the use of telecommunications devices. Computers, phones, and smartwatches are namely some of the most popular devices used by people in today's world. Over 80% of the population have become accustomed to these technologies. With communication, entertainment, navigation, productivity, and the rest of the world at your literal fingertips, how could you resist? Or rather, could you even resist in the first place?
I think I checked my screen time a month or two ago. It was at like 8 hours, and I'm not kidding. 8 hours average daily. That's like most of my day. Most of the time that I was awake, I was just on my phone scrolling in my bedroom. Like, I wasn't doing anything. I felt lazy. I felt like unproductive every single day. And so I was like, I'm just gonna try and put it down. I'm gonna try doing things I actually like. And now my screen time's at 5 hours, which I feel like still isn't good. That's like the same amount of time I'm in school every day. But but I feel like it's still down.
There's definitely been a few times that I've thought that I'm like, you know, just before you go to bed, you might get bored, you go on your phone, scroll a while, and then it causes you to go to bed later and not wake up with enough sleep. I think just managing time better with it is a good idea. Giving yourself like 20 to 30 minutes here and there to maybe go on it, or like before you go to bed, but then you go to bed on time. You know, like just having good control over yourself, that's really it.
In the current age of communication, the effects of overuse of these technologies, namely smartphones, have begun to show. Smartphone use has steadily risen over the years. In the United States alone, a staggering 47% of people believe that they are addicted to their smartphones.
Phone addiction now definitely is a real thing. It's evident throughout, like every single day you see people, like even outside of school, just like on their phones. And it's the distraction it causes. It's sucking people away from like reality. So it's making people just brainless.
I'm even addicted to my phone. My friends might be addicted to their phones. People can miss time in their lives just on their phone looking down. People can miss beautiful things in their life because they're just scrolling on TikTok. Like, I wish I could delete TikTok, delete Instagram, all of that. I can't. Like, I am addicted to it.
Among these people, 66% of teenagers spend 4 or more hours on their phones. Unfortunately, I find myself falling into this category quite often, currently averaging around 5 hours or more across all my devices. Not only does this impede on day-to-day life, but physical communication in the first place.
When I was a kid, I would hang out with my family all the time. And I get it, like everybody grows up, you don't hang out with your family like all the time, 24/7. There's a lot of moments when I am like gaming or on my phone or whatever, when I should be with them. And I guess there's a bit of guilt there. It's present with my family, but it may also be present with my friends, like just at lunch on my phone scrolling, that kind of thing, when I could be hanging out with them. I feel like it definitely does impact those relationships a bit.
Across the generations of millennials and Gen Z, they are reportedly more likely to communicate digitally rather than physically. And the recently coined Gen Alpha will promptly follow suit as they've been born into this new age of digital dependence. Of course, with most things in life, there is a sweet spot. Rather than favoring one form of communication for another, a healthy balance can be achieved by using both.
My final message for people that might be addicted to their phones is to definitely seek more connection outside of digital communication. Like, if you have a way to find more friends at school, you know, like, that you can talk to in person, people that aren't too far away to be meeting up in person, just anyone that's close and easy contact.
I know it's hard to drop the highs and lows, the fun, the humor, maybe not be as up to date as all the like trends and stuff that's circulating. It's worth it. Like, just being outside and enjoying what's actually out there, hanging out with your friends. Go out for drinks with your friends. Go get some bubble tea or go get some food. Go watch a movie, you know? Those connections are the things that actually keep you happy and strong and healthy in your life. Like, it's so worth it. So just try.
Okay.